Hi, and welcome to this video on the general rules of triangles. Today we're going to look at the four most important properties of triangles. The first property is known as the triangle inequality theorem. It states that no side of a triangle can be longer than the other two sides added together. Let's look at this triangle. As you can see, one of the sides is a lot longer than each of the other two sides. But when we measure the sides, the length of the smaller sides added together is still longer than the length of the longer side. If I pushed the top of this triangle lower, the sides would get a bit shorter, but they'd still add up to a little more than 15. If I flattened them completely so that they'd form a straight line segment, they would add up to 15, but then we wouldn't have a triangle anymore. Feel free to try it yourself. Cut a few different straight sticks of different lengths and try to arrange them in a triangle with one of the sides longer than the other two combined. There's just no way to make it connect as a triangle. For our second property, let's move from a rule about the sides of a triangle to one about the angles inside the triangle. You probably remember that the angles inside any triangle always add up to 180 degrees. Since that's true, we can't have a triangle with two angles that are 90 degrees, a right angle, or more than 90 degrees, an obtuse angle. The reason why is simple. There wouldn't be any degrees left to make the third angle. 90 degrees plus 90 degrees plus a third angle equals 180 degrees. The third angle here would have to be 0 degrees, and an angle with that measure isn't an angle at all. It's even worse if we use obtuse angles. 100 degrees plus 95 degrees plus a third angle equals 180 degrees. Here our third angle would need to be negative 15 degrees. That's just not gonna work to make a triangle. For the third property, we're going to examine the relationship between the sides of a triangle and their lengths. But first we need to define the term congruent. Congruent sides of a triangle are sides that are the same length. The length of a side congruent to a side that measures 5 centimeters would be 5 centimeters. The same is true for angles. In any triangle, if we have two sides that are congruent, then the two angles that are opposite those sides will also be congruent. This will always be true, no matter how long the two sides are or how tiny or big the angles are. We can see that in this triangle, which is an isosceles triangle. For our final property, let's look at this triangle. Here we have a line segment in green that connects the midpoint of one side to the midpoint of another side. Whenever you do this in a triangle, the line segment you created is always half the length of the side you didn't bisect. Not only that, it's parallel to that side too. As you can see, triangles are amazing shapes with all sorts of cool properties. Thanks for watching and happy studying.